Hi there, future cadavers of America. Boy, this is shaping up to be a grim Halloween. I'm not going to sugarcoat it for you, kids. The world's going down the toilet. There's Iraq, there's Hurricane Katrina, there's Steven Seagal.
Steven Seagal is here, y'all, to fuss at you.
If those people get hungry enough, he's in trouble. And don't forget the price of gas. This guy, out of work. The president wants us to save gas, but the Texas handsaw massacre?
Be sure not to slap away this terrifying floppy murder weapon.
Other tools haven't worked so well either. Nope. And things just keep getting worse.
Class? My name is Dr. Zangor, and I will be your instructor. This is our first class in intelligent design, or as I like to call it, guessing.
Oh boy.
You see, evolution doesn't adequately explain the complexities of human life.
But look, as bad as things get, somebody's always got it worse. Like the people in these movies on DVD. The family moves into a ginormous house in the Amityville Horror.
There was a tragedy, a crime, a murder.
I'm sorry, what?
In the house?
But they get a deal on it. The remake of the 1979 version claims it's based on the true story of the Lutz family, but the real George Lutz sued the studio. This dude insists he really wasn't a possessed homicidal maniac. Now who's gonna sue the studio for making this too much like The Shining? Besides, the movie's really about this bodybuilder, walking around without a shirt and soaking wet. Oh, daddy, please.
Existence. Rabbits, which seem so cuddly as pets, can become a menace.
For real suffering, we turn to a classic just released on DVD. Night of the Lepus is the Schindler's List of giant, homicidal, cute bunny movies. Have you ever heard these words before anything good happened?
Would you give me a clean rabbit?
Oh, yeah.
Maybe your kids saw Wallace and Gromit, Curse of the Were-Rabbit in theaters, and they wanted more. Just tell them this is Alice in Wonderland, The Revenge. I'm late, for a very important mass homicide.
Now, Sheriff, when those rabbits start coming, they could be here in a couple of hours. Will that give you enough time to evacuate the town?
Not all of it. There are a lot of trailer courts and ranches spread around, many of them without telephones.
These FEMA guys never could do anything right.
It's a fence about 10 miles long and 20 feet high.
And when we say there had to be an intelligent designer, that doesn't necessarily mean God, this being a public school and all. Hey, it could have been this guy. Who did that?
You know how it works. Those who can't do, teach. And this isn't the first job he's had since he lost his own horror hosting position.
Here at erotten.scum, we use all the technology and juju at our disposal to find you the perfect soulmate.
You really complete me. And by that I mean, I took some of her organs. It's all about the O.
Oh!
It's all about the O.
No!
It's all about the O.
No!
Respect your teachers. Who else is going to prepare you for your career by crushing your spirit and stamping out your individuality?
I believe that children are our future, because someday we'll be able to blame them for everything we've screwed up.
Who's got it worse than zombies? The the stiffness, the B.O. It was 20 years since George Romero had been able to get the dough together to make a zombie movie, and it took the success of all the George Romero rip-offs like Resident Evil to make it possible. What sets the genuine article apart? Social commentary, for one, with the have-not zombies marching on the rich survivors. If that's too subtle, Romero says it's George Bush's America in an interview on the DVD.
We don't negotiate with terrorists. We have other options.
And the unrated edition has so much more gore than anyone saw in theaters that it'll put you off buffalo wings for the evening. If Foster's is Australian for beer, then Undead must be Australian for zombie.
Bugger me!
Bodies don't seem to have a lot of connective tissue down under. This one's a cheap little snoozer. But it does have, to my knowledge, the very first zombie fish in the history of cinema. And a glimpse of the future Mrs. Ron Popeil. All right, I Walk With a Zombie is a silly title. I wonder what they'd call this one if they'd remake it. How about I Jogged With a Zombie? Or I Went to a Spinning Class With a Zombie? Right, silly title. But it's one of the beautiful, atmospheric thrillers from legendary producer Val Lewton, and it's on a double bill with Lewton's The Body Snatcher. It's sort of a Jane Eyre set in the West Indies with a zombie. Val Lewton was no George Romero when it came to social commentary, but then...
And the enormous boat brought the long-ago fathers and the long-ago mothers of us all chained to the bottom of the boat.
They brought you to a beautiful place, didn't they?
If you say, miss, if you say.
Kids, meet the young Barbara Bush. This zombie thing is working out quite well for them.
I'll be glad when you're dead, you rascal, you. I'll be glad when you're dead, you rascal, you. You know you've done me wrong. You stole my wife and gone. I'll be glad when you're dead, you rascal, you.
Talk about it, Jordan, talk about it.
I'm gonna kill you just for fun, you rascal, you. I'm gonna kill you just for fun, you rascal, you. I'm gonna kill you just for fun. The bugs can have you when I'm done. I'll be glad when you're dead, you rascal, you.
Ah, let me talk about him a while. Now, there ain't no use to you running, you old rascal, you.
Run, Satch!
There ain't no use to him running, you rascal, you.
Catch up with him, catch up with him.
Ain't no use to you to run, because I done went to the pawn shop and got my gun.
You messed with my wife, rascal. Yes, you messed with my wife, you rascal.
You know who else has it bad? Rich, dim-witted hotel heiresses. At least in House of Wax, not to mention the SATs. Poor Paris Hilton.
Goldfish, put down that damn camera.
Hey, I thought she liked being videotaped.
She's messing around, though.
She's in a group of annoying young people that includes the annoying daughter from 24. They bust this redneck's headlight with a bottle and then find out that the House of Wax isn't where you go to get a Brazilian. It's in a creepy little town where most of the residents are made of wax, but are still better actors. Hello, is this thing on?
It is wax. Like, literally.
Theater audiences erupted in cheers when they saw Paris get whacked here, and missing out on that group experience is the one disadvantage of seeing it on DVD. But there's a bunch of extra material that shows the huge amount of money and work from people including the producer of The Matrix that went into the amazing sets for this idiotic story.
The wall walker's right behind you!
Also this week, in annoying groups of pretty young people, yet another direct-to-video installment in the Hellraiser series. I hope those nitwit politicians who scapegoat video games for real-life violence don't catch this one, because it starts with an evil game that gets people all bent out of shape.
Oh, Derek.
And it leads these friends to a big, evil house party.
Have a high tolerance, do you?
The props are cool, but this is just an old house. Lima Shaw is a character from some scary story. The puzzle box, a myth, and Hell World, it's just a game.
Let me translate. Please kill me and all my friends, horribly, one at a time.
Where am I?
I have as much nerd love for Bruce Campbell as any horror fan, but guess which part of me wound up screaming in The Man with the Screaming Brain? It was a little lower than the brain. Campbell also wrote and directed this really painful horror comedy in Bulgaria, and it looks as cheap as, well, as the video you're watching right now. And finally, the best title of this Halloween, Your Vice is a Locked Room, and Only I Have the Key. It's a good little Italian slasher flick from 72, like Edgar Allan Poe's Black Cat story, if Poe was into nudity and gore. But the best thing about it is the title, which, by the way, is Your Vice is a Locked Room, and Only I Have the Key. I believe they kicked around some sequel titles. Your Vice is the Trunk of a Ford Escort, and Only I Have the Keyless Remote. And Your Vice was in the couch cushions, and I found it when I was digging for the TV thing. Intelligent design. Sounds more like aggressive ignorance to me. For instance, how do you explain little things like fossils?
I have a lot of balls bouncing in the air. And how do you have a social,
You can't. Look, Arthur C. Clarke once said any sufficiently advanced technology would be indistinguishable from magic. Look, most of us can't even figure out how to send an email attachment, let alone the complexities of human life.
You don't know what the hell you're talking about.
Very good.
Anyhow, I think we've heard the last of this intelligent design stuff from the doctor for the time being.
Don't you judge me.